stop clock on the change of possession. Or they may be talking about why not run the football here, throw a little screen pass, eat up some time on the clock and keep the clock running. They would like for, they would actually like for the Houston to have to use the other timeout.
And again, we'll remind you, 60 minutes. You know, 4 years ago, a giant American chemical company was told by one of its own engineers that it was slowly contaminating water wells adjoining the plant. Did the company do anything about it? Well, you'll find out as you watch 60 Minutes tonight.
Oh, come on, tell me.
I'll never tell. Never tell. There's the timeouts remaining.
Just one timeout. They would like for the Oilers to have to use that timeout if they can get them. The Peach Bowl, Clemson versus Baylor, huh?
And we'll also have our producer Bob Rowe and Jim Sillman as we invade Atlanta. Go down there. And
they're going, huh?
Yes, they are. We go together as a team. Third down, 12 yards to go. They've decided what they're going to do, and let's see what it is. Walton's going to throw it, but he's going to play it very safe. As he didn't see anything developing on that, he tossed it away. Jamona was the closest man to the football, but as you said, that stopped the clock.
Well, it did stop the clock. Robert Brazil had played that perfectly. He had to throw the ball away because that could have been intercepted if he had tried to complete it. Just got word on that Dallas game, and Dallas has the ball on its own 45-yard line with a minute 18 to play. You see Walton going back right here and making sure that he throws the ball out of bounds, because you see 52, Robert Brazil was right on the play.
Runninger to kick. The Oilers will have their offense ready to go. And with a minute 49, they'll have some time. Ellender at the 12. He's got to get to the 15, and that's all. Good coverage that time by Philadelphia, and in particular, Jerry Robinson. He really gets down there in a hurry. 41-yard kick by Runninger. There's the time. You see it. Upper right-hand portion of your screen. A 15-yard line, and a minute 37 to get down to the other end.
And the one timeout hurt him. Remember the timeout that Gifford Nielsen had to take when he was standing at the line of scrimmage because he had a bad formation. And you see right up in the upper right-hand corner, I think that's gonna, they're gonna remember that one.
Philadelphia, whose goal this year was to win 10 games, trying to go one over that. Nielsen trying to deliver the football on the far side for Jeff Groth. Brings up second and 10. Very well covered that time by the Eagles. You know, it's interesting. About 4 or 5 weeks ago, Vermeil said, we'll have to win 10 games to get into the playoff. He was exactly right. At that time, everybody thought 9 would. And he said, after they won their 10th game, that was their goal. Last year, they won 9. Now they have a chance to win 11. Nielsen back again on second and 10. Wide open is Groth. I don't know what happened. He didn't locate the football. Interesting how wide open Groth was on that play.
He ran a corner pattern, but the ball was delivered before he went back on his break. And when you do that, when you make that type of throw, you're trying to guess at what angle a man is going to come out of his break. And you see he's back. He wants to throw the ball a long way because they need a big play right now. He gets it away, has a lot on the football. If he'd have laid it up just a little bit, he may have, Groth may have been able to make a play on it.
Henry Monroe now checks in at a cornerback for Philadelphia. John Sanders coming off. And a third down catch by Caster, and he has a first down. Caster with a lunging catch for the first down. Henry Monroe ran him out of bounds, and the Oilers are still alive with a minute 20 left in this game.
Not only a first down and an excellent catch and throw, but he gets the first down and stops the clock. You take a look. Philadelphia playing very loose this time, protecting against the bomb. Caster comes across underneath the linebackers. You see how deep the linebackers are, about 20 yards deep. Castie gets the first down. As you said, is still alive. They got a minute 20 left.
12-yard pickup on the play. Nielsen delivering again. Merkins. Blackmore defending on that play. They had Sanders in there that time. Blackmore, Herman Edwards. Anybody that can play defensive back, they're going to have him in now.
Again, they're trying to go to that type of pattern. It's a long pattern, but you're throwing it outside. They're throwing it before the break. If he catches it, he stops the clock. He's out of bounds. But they're having trouble connecting on it.
There's the time left. Well, it hasn't been easy for Philadelphia or Houston this year. They've had a lot of close games. Oilers winning two of them in overtime as you look at Phillips along with Pastorini. And it's come down to the last game of the year and they're fighting and scratching. Nielsen to Merkins. He almost had it. That would have been a great catch. Randy Logan defending. Just couldn't quite get up high enough.
I tell you, he had Rich Caster wide open that time. He has Caster wide open. You see him going back. There's a post pattern this time, a little change up from the pattern they threw before. He does take something off of this ball. He lays it up. If it goes over, it's almost intercepted. You see standing right behind it, Edwards standing there waiting for the interception.
Third down, 10. Minute 9 left in the game. Nielsen to Merkins again, intercepted this time. Picked off by Chesley. His second interception of the year. And I like this guy out of Pittsburgh. The rookie who had an interception earlier in Veterans Stadium comes up with one here. And with 59 seconds left, the Eagles have survived the Oilers' attempt to come from behind.
I tell you what, that game, and you take a look at this interception, and then I'll tell you what's happening across state. The linebacker's deep. Anytime you're throwing against linebackers this deep and you see him jump, tips the ball with one hand, comes down and makes the interception. Great play by Chesley. Dallas has the ball on the Washington's 8-yard line with 45 seconds to play. How close are you winning the division or being eliminated from the playoffs?
That's right.
Your whole season goes down to 45 seconds.
That's right. Philadelphia, of course, winning here. But they had to have a tie in that game in order to win the division. Larry Barnes, Houston has one timeout left. Are they going to use it? Clock still winding down. And now they will use the timeout. Houston has no timeouts remaining. Well, I have to say this about Philadelphia. I have been so impressed with them this year. But I'm also impressed with that team that's wearing the Columbia blue and red. A lot of character on both of these teams.
RCA wants you to see the right color. Sunrise over the Grand Canyon. Does your television capture the color in all its intensity, in all its subtlety? Does it automatically show you the right shades of color? If not, wait till you see ColorTrack 1980. ColorTrack 1980, with 8 automatic color systems designed to lock even subtle shades of color on track. RCA is making television better and better.
Sharp razor blades are designed to give you a closer shave. Great for my beard, but can still be irritating to my skin. So I help protect my skin with Rise. Rise is thicker than the leading foam. Look, I can't even shake it off. Rise helps protect my skin against irritation. So for today's close shaves, get today's thick Rise.
...60 minutes following football as the Houston Oilers have just used their last timeout. And we had an offside against Houston. Let's go now to Brent Musburger in New York.
Gary, thank you very much. Back here in New York, we have had a dramatic turnaround with less than a minute to go. Roger Staubach has driven the Dallas Cowboys back and they are tied with the Washington Redskins, waiting now to set up the extra point. This is the pass that established it for the Cowboys. He hit Preston Pearson, then he ran Tony Hill into the corner with 42 seconds, lobbed it up over the head, and the kick is good. Now down in Dallas. So as a result of these 7 points, the Cowboys lead the Redskins 35-34. What a game. Back now to Gary Bender in Houston.
Thank you, Brett. And so, if that stays as it is, Washington will not be in the playoffs. That incredible, Sonny?
Incredible that it comes down to the last 45 seconds. I see the Philadelphia bench right now. They're looking at the clock. They see the tie score. They have the wrong score on the scoreboard. They think they're going into overtime in Dallas, and they would have a chance to win the division.
Somebody ought to alert them down there. That's got to be agony for those players on the sideline and the coaches. Look at them. They're looking around. Now they put it out. Dallas. Now that's interesting the way they reacted to that, isn't it?
It really is.
Why would they feel that one way or another?
Maybe that's who they want to play in the playoffs.
Well, they will play Chicago. I guess you understand that now. That is it. And that is it. So the final score, 26-20, Philadelphia picking up their 11th win. They'll be in the wild card against Chicago if that Dallas and Washington game stays the same. This is Gary Bender for Sonny Jurgensen saying so long from the Houston Astrodome. Let's go now to Irving, Texas for the conclusion of that Dallas-Washington game.
High deep kick, chases Hammond back to the goal line. And Bobby Hammond streaks to the outside, is down at the 25 where the Redskins will take over. They have two timeouts left. It looked as if the game was in the bag for Washington. If you look at that frantic bench at the moment, Theismann will of course be the quarterback.
What a job. What a job the Skins have done with this team.
Mark Mosley, loosening up behind the bench, knows what might be facing him. Redskin kicker get hit from 50 yards.